Hey guys, it's Adrian from adriancgmask.com, and in this tutorial I will show you the fastest and easiest way to create a high poly object inside of 3ds Max. Be aware, this method only works inside of 3ds Max using modifier that called data channel to let the 3ds Max knows we need all the hard edges to be sharp into the subdivision. Alright, but beforehand we have to be sure we gotta have a decent topology to begin with, like all contained of quads. We don't need to have we have a star here. It gives us obviously very bad topology no matter what tools we use. This is a bad topology here. It should all be quads, beautiful, like here. And for instance, we gotta have at least one edge loops in each hard edges, right here in the middle, for instance here in the cylinder. We better have a edge loop here as well, here as well. It will work, but it gives us a much better result in this subdivision. Alright, let's get to it. Before I go to the data channel, I want to address this. Before, I always use Creaset, but the problem I have with the Creaset is that when I go to the Creaset at a Creaset modifier and put it like a 45 angle and select all the edges and add a Creaset like one, another open subdivision on top of that, it gives us a very good result in very short amount of time. You need to obviously tweak a couple of edges here and there, but it gives us a very good result. But the downside is, it's when I go back and try to delete some edges in the editable poly, I come back to open subdiv and boom, this creasing does not work. It will break because of I just delete one edge. That's why I always use data channel or the chamfer modifier. Alright, let's try first. Let's try and make this little guy here high poly. Selected. This is a very good topology, all quads, but we need to add a couple, help him a little bit. We insert these faces at the end around this corner. I just not very close at the corner, but just add a couple of edge loop here and there in here as well. Help him out a little bit in here. Nice. Let's see. Yeah, well, it's all work pretty good. All right, let's go to the modifier list and then the data channel. Data channel, let's go to the preset and select arrow edge crease weights and load it right here. And now we will gives us these highlights. Then we can disable it here, enable display. Now we add the open subdiv on top of that to see the end result here, like deselecting it and see the result. Out of the box, we have a it will make all the edges sharp. We have to go back to the data channel and refine it a bit. Let's go to the curve control and pick this dot here and move it to the right until we get a value like 0.5. usually in most cases 0.5 value always works. Close that and let's go back to the data channel and boom, that's it. That's all. It gives us this beautiful, perfect result. Take care of all these edges just by one or two clicks on the mouse. We get our high poly. Nice. And the best thing about the data channel is if you go back to the edible poly, we can, like, for instance, let's extrude this one as well. Let's just add a edge loop here, just here and there, and let's just remove some edge loops like here and here. So if you go back to the open sub, it should broke like a crease, right? But let's see the results. Nothing. It hold its shape beautiful. Even we extrude this face here, it gives us a hard edge. Beautiful. We can't address it enough. This is the best high poly modifier method ever exists. It does not broke, and we have much more power over this. This is a procedural way to create a high poly, but we can simply add a poly modifier on top of that and select like this edge and this one as well. I just can just go to edge subject level, edit edges, and increase the creasing, and go back to the open subdiv. Now we have creasing right here, so we have control over the every single edge on this mesh. Is super fast, super quick, super easy. Nice. Let's go back and try data channel on this big guy here. Let's do the same thing here and more complex shape like this one. We can see both like a cylindrical here, box shape here. All right, let's see what we got. Auto save, go to preset, auto edge crease weight loaded, go to the curve, and let's just first go to the this one as well. Let's add the open sub the modifier on top so we can see the results. Show and result, turn that on, go back to the curve control, and let's see the result here. Alright, we got a bad result here. Let's just lower the value here to something like 0.7. Now we get a much better result all around. Beautiful. Simply by just pick this dot here and just left and right, we get a harder edge, softer edge, like that. And for this part, we have to manually select these edges and crease it. Now let's just further refine it by adding an edit poly on top. Go to the select and just select all the edges on the corner right here, here as well, here as well. You have to select all these edges, and we need to sharpen this edge as well. This couple of tweaking and further refinements is a necessity in order to get a perfect high poly object. Here as well, let's select this corner here, here, and here, just like that. Here as well, it doesn't take a lot of time. You just select the corner here like that, and after we select the all these edges on the corner that needs to be sharp. You go to the edit edge and edit edges and increase the creasing, put a crease like one value, and let's see the results here and here. Give it some time. It's a bit slow using a data channel. Nice, we have a very beautiful result here. Like here, we don't select this edge. Go back to the edible poly, and if we select it, we get a beautiful sharp edge here and here as well. Increase the creasing, put it at one, go back, and let's see the results. Alright, now we have a beautiful result here. You can select the rest of this, it's up to you, but look at here, we have a beautiful sharp edges here. For here as well, we select these edges on the corner here and here, and we just put the crease value to 1, and it will fix all this black artifact here. And that's it. We have a control over each individual edges here by using the data channel, and at the edit poly modifier on top, we get a perfect high poly object inside of 3ds Max. Alright, that was the end of this tutorial. Be sure to subscribe, hit that thumbs up button, and see you guys on the next video. Take care.